Hello, hi you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, you read the title already. We are going to again try a lot of inexpensive makeup from Amazon. So I've done this video before. It did really well. You guys found a lot of things you like as well. So I thought I'll do a part two of it. I have so many new products to try, like they're just in front of me and I'm so excited. Okay, before we dive in these products, I just want to mention that all the links of the products will be in the description bar. You can check them out. I bought them on Amazon and they have the great Indian festive sale going on, where you have numerous multiple amazing offers going on from beauty, fashion, gadgets, anything you like. So if you're interested, I will leave that link. Also, you can check Amazon and get shopping. But now let's test some really inexpensive makeup I have in front of me. I'm very excited because last time we found a lot of favorites. So let's go. Okay, I've done my foundation and I use the Maybelline Fit Me Matte Plus, a poreless. You know the drill, I don't like to risk my skin with like an inexpensive foundation because the ingredients might be nasty and my skin is already pretty delicate these days. So you get the version of this in a tube, which is just $299, and I don't think it gets better than that. You get a really good foundation for $299. So moving on to concealer, which I got. So I got a Blue Heaven concealer. One thing which was kind of annoying, especially when these like things are so inexpensive, you have to buy everything in two, like this one and like a contour bronzer. I could not buy one because the minimum quantity was two. I got this Blue Heaven flawless liquid concealer and this is 160 rupees. This is the MRP basically, but I've gotten it for even lesser. All the prices will be on the screen or like always. So it's a tube, so this reminds me of the pack concealer, by the way. It's the same, like, you know, tube and all. Right off, smells like that Pond's Pins powder, and literally like the same smell. Every time I use these products, I get the same smell. Last time I've used Blue Heaven's some powder and it literally had the same scent. So enter. Okay, so the next one I have is a cream blush. Basically, every time I do my base these days, I always go in with like a cheek tint or a cream blush. So I got this Shariette cream illuminating blush. It's basically just like a matte creamy blush. It's like this. I got this color because they had multiple colors. I was just like sure I can make this work, so I got this one. So I'm just going to like go in with it. For starters, like nothing is coming much on the brush. On my hand, it's not that pigmented, so let's just blend it on the face and see. Just leaving on the concealer so that I get more coverage, in case you're wondering why I left it there and I'm doing my blush. Okay, in the pan, in the pot, it does not look like shiny, but you can see there's like that glow to it. When you look at this, you apply it, it's there. So that's, I think that's why they call it like illuminating blush. It kind of gives you that glow. And if you know me, I don't like blushes which give me a glow, because I do have textured skin, I have acne prone skin. So anything which is a little shiny kind of tends to exaggerate my texture, which I don't usually prefer. I use, that's why I'm using a lot of mattifying things. So anyways, that kind of blended well. The color is also kind of like, you know, I don't mind, it's pretty only. This concealer has oxidized so much. Oh my god, so much. Because initially when I applied it, it did not look like this at all. Can you see that? Can you see that difference? This is what when I applied and now it looks like this. Oh my god, that is a lot of difference, like a lot of difference. And it dried down so much that I'm not able to blend it now. Okay, this is for sure not a concealer you can leave there to dry down, because it literally clings on. I just want to see how it will be like if I just blend it out immediately. Okay, I just had a huge 1 hour interruption because something happened and I had to stop filming. So anyways, the concealer, first impressions, do not like it at all. Especially if you have dry skin, dry under eyes, it clings on to it so much. So it's clearly not working for me. So I'm just going to add another concealer so that at least this look does not look so bad, because the color is absolutely like too dark on me. See, the same, even that concealer was this color when I applied it, but it oxidized like so much. Okay, my under eyes do look a little heavy. That's because I had to add like two different layers of two different concealers. But at least overall, it does make my face look a little more bright rather than dull and dead. Okay, moving on to powder, I have the Insight Cosmetics HD Finishing Loose Powder. So this is how the powder looks. It's basically a colored powder. So powder is kind of setting things, but it's also kind of adding a layer and a color there, which I don't usually like. I'm just going to add something on my lips because it feels so chapped. The powder is setting everything, but it does add right. You can see it under the eye, and if you're somebody who likes coverage and color from powder, it's fine. I don't like my powder to do anything or add anything except set my makeup in place, and hence I usually go with like translucent powders. But this one is, you know, adding that more yellowish color under my eye. You can see how bright the concealer was. This kind of toned down that one. Moving on to bronzer or contour, I have Eyetic Dazzler Compact Powder. This is basically, they have multiple shades and they have one shade which is called contour. So I think, like, you know, they thought we'll make one bronzer shade and it'll be enough for everybody. But it does look pretty dark and pretty intense and might suit like most of the skin tones, but for me personally only it seems too dark. But yeah, let's try. So this is how it looks, and this retails for ₹80. Start that. I knew how cool toned it is. Like, even when you look at it in the pan, you can see how gray and neutral and how deep it is. So I kind of did expect that. Oh my god, can you see how bad my nose looks? It is so damn, it's bad. The color is bad. The product is kind of good. It is blending in very, very well. Usually when I go with bronzer, I do the same thing, but it does not look as bad. But that's also my fault. I should have, you know, gone a little light-handed because it's a new product and I don't know how it looks. See, I just blended it off and it looks a lot better. So on the perimeters, it still is fine, but on the nose, it's kind of too harsh. But that's actually really nice that for once they're actually catering to the people who are deeper. Next, for blush, I went ham and bought a whole ass blush palette. This is the Swiss Beauty Ultra Blush palette. So this is for $4.99, but of course I got it for less. So it has four blush shades and four kind of highlighting shades. Okay, so these are all the shades swatched. These are the four highlighters and these are the four blushes. The blushes do seem good and pigmented. The highlighters I have not a lot of hope for. I'm going to take this shade and I'm using the same brush I always use. This is the Sheen brush, and I'm just going to kind of pat it on the high points. But like, you know, contour is too muddy, so I'm going to go a little overboard on the blush because I don't want to look like as ashy as I do. I don't mind looking pink, and we're going to go a little extra on the eyes, so it kind of will get balanced out. Don't, like, you know, worry about it looking too much. Oh my god, this blush is so pretty. I really like this blush. That color, the way it blended, actually really good. Okay, for highlighter, you can try the same palette, but I wanted to, you know, give you more options. So this is called Shrayon, I think, Shrayon Shimmer Palette. It has eight different shades. So these are all the eight shades swatched. This one probably swatched the most beautifully. Also, I'm going to take this and kind of mix it with this shade, and I'm going to hit on the high points. Oh my god, that's low-key really nice. It's for $3.75. Next, for brows, I have the Hilary Rhoda Eyebrow Pencil. So it has the spoolie on one side and it has the, you know, brow pencil on the other. The tip seems nice and fine. Okay, next, for eyeshadow, I've not bought like any new eyeshadow palette. When I did order it, I thought so, but I've reviewed this before and I actually really like this one. But there are a lot of different eye products. Like, I've got glitters here. Oh my god, I can't believe how beautiful they look. I'm really excited to try them. I have liquid eyeshadow. So I just want to like create a base for my eyes, and I'm going to go in with this Hilary Rhoda eyeshadow palette. It's a very like proper neutral eyeshadow palette. There's a colorful version of this which is really beautiful. You get both for under 400 or something, and they really work well. So I'm just going to take these two shades and kind of create a transition. Next, I'm going to go in and take this deep pink plum type of shade. There's a little bit of blending work you have to do with these shadows, but if you do that, you'll get like a beautiful look. Okay, now the one I'm so beyond excited for. So this was the first product which got delivered in everything I ordered, and I could not wait to try these on. Wait a minute. I got literally 12 beautiful glitters for such an amazing deal. I am going to go in with this pink one now. Look at those stunning glitters. So they even gave a glitter glue with it. So I'm using the same one. The glue they gave is so like jelly. Look how stunning that looks. I'm usually not like a huge... what do you say, glitter person? I don't use glitter in my makeup a lot because I don't know, I find it kind of chunky. But when I saw this, I got so excited to try it because this is not just like normal, you know, glitter. It's a kind of, I don't know how to explain it, not just basic shimmery metallic kind of glitter. Probably do, if you're playing with glitter, it's better you first do your, you know, eyes and then do your base, because once the glitter is on your face, it's not going anywhere. Going to go ahead and add a little bit of this dark color on the outer edge to add a little more, you know, definition to it. Smoke it out a little bit. So okay, for lashes, so these lashes I've used a lot of times, especially initially when I had no money to buy anything else. So basically these are the five, these are literally the same kind, but I have eyes which cannot like look good with big voluminous lashes. The minute I wear them, they completely cover my eyes and it looks so bad. And I always go with something which is very light ones, like the pack ones or something, and these are also something I really really like. So I'm just going to pop these lashes on, do a little bit of lower lash eyeshadow, and I'll be right back. Okay, lashes are on, but I forgot how much pain these lashes are. Because they're so thin, they're kind of flimsy and it's so difficult to get them on. But once they're on, it looks beautiful, but it's so difficult to get them on, and it took me so much time now just to put on lashes. I added the same eyeshadow and glitter on the lower lash line as well, and now we finally just have few lipsticks left. Lipsticks I have Inside Cosmetics Matte Lip Ink. The Inside Matte Lipstick. Love the packaging, how matte it is. I think I'm going to mix both these shades. First, I'll just apply Bougie and see. Actually, I heard one of my friends, she's also a creator, Bhavna, talk about this shade, so I got this one. On days when your eye makeup is so extravagant and you just want to trim down your lips, this is such a beautiful shade. I would really leave this here. I love the shade for this look. But just so you know how this other shade looks, I'm going to put this on as well. But this is such a stunning shade. Oh my god. If you're a little deeper than me, then you can use like a lip liner and then use this. If you're lighter, it'll be a beautiful nude. If you're my skin tone, it's a beautiful nude. Okay, I have one last product left to try. This is from Miss Claire. It's basically a white kajal pencil, and I really wanted to see how it'll work because it's just for 100 or something, and if this works, I would like love to buy more colors. Okay, that's the final look, you guys. Let's quickly run through all the products I've used and I'll give you my final thoughts. First one, we used the Blue Heaven Concealer. Big pass for me. Did not like the color. It oxidized so much. It clinged on to dry patches. It's very inexpensive, but I don't really like it. There was another concealer I really liked, I think in the previous one, you can check that video out. And that also I have a lot of inexpensive favorites. I will link all those videos too. Then the next one we tried is the Charlotte New York Cream Illumination Blush. I do really like it. It did have a little sheen to it, but once I set it with powder, it did just have color and no shine. So if you get this one for like under 200 or 300, then definitely go for this one. But if it's more than that, then I don't think it's worth it. If it's more than that, Amazon also has like Rene Cosmetics, which I really like there. Cheek tints also look exactly like this and they are not shiny. They're really nice when it comes to the pigmentation. So you can try that one. But if it's, you know, this under like 300, then definitely you can try. Then the next one we tried is the Swiss Beauty Blush Palette. Oh my god, I really like this one. The blush is on point. It's matte. It blended beautifully. It has multiple different colors. It has corals, pinks, and even has the highlighters. I've not tried the highlighter, but the blushes are amazing. Then moving on to highlighter, we've tried this palette for highlighter. This is Shrayon. I don't know how to pronounce this. Shrayon. And love it. Stunning. I mean, you can see how properly glowy it is. It's not very like, you know, glossy, creamy kind. But if you do want a highlighter which is inexpensive and you have multiple colors and it does give you like enough shine, then you can definitely try this one. You can see if I, you know, when the light hits, it does look nice. But when you normally see me, you don't have any gray cast. So it does not look chunky or shimmery. And that's a really good sign for highlighter. And I really like this highlighter palette. So okay, next we use this Itex Dazzler Contour Powder. So if you're somebody who's deeper in skin tone, more deeper than me, so if you're like NC 45 and up, you might really really like this one, because for me personally it was too deep and too cool. But when it comes to blending, it did blend very beautifully and there's no patchiness or anything. So probably it's like a color preference. So if you're somebody who, you know, is a deeper skin tone, you might really like this one. It's just literally 80 rupees, and you can see my forehead is nice and contoured. I only use this, I didn't use anything else, and it looks decent enough. Okay, next for brow pencil, I tried this Hilary Rhoda brow pencil. It's just 100 rupees, and I think it's really nice. It did fill in my brows. It's a little too dark, kind of like a charcoal black. I like something which is like a charcoal gray, if it makes sense. But again, it did work well and I would like use it again. It did give me nice filling, it gave me nice strokes. The tip is nice. It's not too pigmented, not too less pigmented. It comes with a spoolie as well, so the brow pencil gets a thumbs up. Star of the show today is this oh my god, this glitters. These are 12 glitters and oh my god, I've never used glitters like this before. Like generally only I've not used glitters, and I really am impressed. I got them just for rupees 250 and they are stunning. You can use them so many different times. You have 12 shades for 250, which is amazing. I don't like the glitter glue though, because everything kind of started falling off, and that's the fault of the glue. I need to use the glue which I have, which I actually like. But other than that, the glitters by itself, stunning. Glitter glue, not so much. Then the Miss Claire White Eye Pencil, not so good. I mean, it just kind of disappeared in the eyes. It is there when you apply it, but later it kind of just like dissolved. So I don't really see a lot of white. And even when I applied, it was not that pigmented. So, I mean, I can get and try more, but it's, I don't know. I don't have that good of an impression yet on this. Lipsticks, stunning shades. You can see how beautiful they look, especially Bougie. I can see myself wearing it so much more often. Such a beautiful neutral shade. Formula is amazing. It's very lightweight, very thin. I don't feel like I'm wearing something on my lips, and it's not drying. Though it's a matte formula, does not feel drying, and that's a really important thing for me. And it does not look also like, you know, cracked and open like few extreme matte liquid lipsticks look. This looks hydrated also, but it's also matte, which is the perfect balance. And I really like the lipsticks. You can definitely try those ones. Forgot about the powder. The powder honestly is a pass for me. Powders I'm very picky about, so I honestly did not even expect to like it so much, especially because it does add that tint of yellow, which I don't really like. It makes it a little heavy. So it did set the concealer properly, and there's like no creasing etc., which means it did its job well. It's just my personal preference that I don't like something which adds that extra color or that coverage to my base. So that's why it's a pass, or not a fan, but it does work. So yeah guys, that's it for the video. I hope you guys liked it and found something you're interested in. I will leave all the links of all the products in the description bar. You can check it out. Again, Great Indian Festive Sale is going on Amazon, so it's a right time to shop because there are amazing sales going on. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then make sure to like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. I'll see you guys in next video. I don't know what I was doing. I was going to say bye, but I was going to give a kiss also. But anyways, bye.